Hi guys, welcome back to the channel for another video. So today I'm with the Suzuki Ignis that's sitting right behind me. So Suzuki calls it a urban SUV, but it's a small hatchback and it's sold exclusively via Nexa outlets. So special thanks to Jorhat Nexa for allowing me to get my hands on the car. So the showroom details will be given in the description below, and you can also see right now running in the screen. So if you want to go for any Nexa product or this Ignis, then make sure you make an inquiry with the showroom details that will be given. And now moving forward, I'll give you a brief walk around of the car and also show it different features. And before starting, if you are new to this channel, then make sure you subscribe to the channel and also press the bell notification icon to get notified every single time I upload a new video to this channel. Also, don't forget to like and share this video. With that said, let's now get started. The Suzuki Ignis, a small hatchback with funky styling that Suzuki calls an urban SUV and sold exclusively via Nexa outlets. Designed especially to attract the youths, it surely looks very different. But it's not the first car to start this segment, and as such, it rivals up against cars like Tata Punch and also Mahindra KV100, which doesn't sell very much. So in this video, we will look in details about its features and equipments on offer, and also if it's a better buy over its rivals like the newly launched Tata Punch. So with that said, let's now get started.
So like always, starting with the keys, here are the keys that you will get with the Suzuki Ignis. Fairly very simple key, to the one side Suzuki logo, to the other side lock and unlock button. So this key I've also seen in other Suzuki cars. There is no like follow me headlight button, neither there is dedicated button to unlock the tailgate, but the tailgate gets request button for unlocking it. If you have the key, press that button, the tailgate will unlock. Also the front doors in this Zeta variant gets request sensor, so press those button. If you have the key with you, the doors will unlock by itself. So keyless entry and exit is there in this car. Now moving forward to the front fascia of the car, this is the front fascia of the car, and this is the facelift model. This particular variant is the Zeta variant, so it doesn't get bi-projector LED headlights. Every single light in this car is halogen. LED projector headlight is there in the top spec Alpha variant, which also gets LED DRL. This car doesn't get DRL and all those sorts of stuff. Then on both the sides you can see like halogen fog lights. So fog lights on all the variants in this car is halogen, and also the rear tail lights in every single variant of this Ignis is halogen. And now talking about like the design of the front, the split grille setup is there. Obviously there is silver skid plating, there is the place for putting the number plate holder. There are no parking sensors on the front. Obviously in this price segment you won't get parking sensors in a car like this. And yeah, now Suzuki in terms of design calls it an urban SUV. It surely does not look like an SUV styling is given, but it's a very small hatchback. And honestly saying, when Suzuki first launched this car, I didn't like the styling, but with time that design eventually grew over me. I kind of like it now. And talking about urban SUV, there is a reason behind that. Obviously styling is there, and also the ground clearance, it's 180 mm and runs on 15 inch wheels. So in terms of like road condition in our country, it's better to have great ground clearance and bigger wheels. So I like it more than the Swift, I have to say that now, because the new Swift I don't like the design much, but this one I do. And now the SUV styling, there is in the grille and also here little bit like elements are given. So very funky styling this car has been like designed to attract the youth. Also you can see roof rails there, and to the side here on the quarter panel, rear quarter panel, you can see these patterns, which really looks very funky, very nice. Obviously there is the spoiler there, rear spoiler. The rear kind of reminds me of the old Suzuki Ritz, so you can say it's a like successor to the Ritz because of the bulged out wheel arches. That is my favorite part actually in this car, these bulged out wheel arches. Obviously there is cladding running across the wheel arches, and also the side is cutting. So very funky looking car. It's like made to appeal the youth, and Suzuki is successful in that. But I have to say Suzuki, like in their lineup, have lots of hatchbacks. Like 50,000 to 40,000 price difference, you will get different sorts of cars, also different variants in this particular model itself. So talking about the variants of the Ignis available in four variants: Sigma, Delta, Zeta, and Alpha. And I've already told you about the Alpha that gets LED front headlights. And engine option in this car is a single 1.2-liter four-cylinder VVT petrol engine. And obviously that comes with both 5-speed manual and an AMT. This particular variant is the AMT variant. Moving to the side profile, this is the side profile of the car. I have obviously shown you the bulged out wheel arches. Really very nice. It looks very premium actually. Like, it kind of looks like a rallycross kind of car. I don't want to say much, but yeah, it's there. So now talking about the wheels. The wheels are 15 inches as I have already told you, and the tire section is 175/65 R15 blacked out alloy wheel like treatment is given. So the front gates ventilated disc, rear obviously gates drums. And in terms of safety, this car comes with dual front airbags, ABS EBD as standard across all variants, and also ISOFIX anchor mounts on the rear seats. So if you want to go for a tall boy kind of car, I have to say better go for the Ignis than the Wagoneer. I have to honestly say that. So the mirrors are placed on the door here, so the blind spot area is less in this car around this A pillar here. And obviously also gets outside ORVM mounted in the mirrors here. And there is the roof rail. As I have already told you, the window sections are big enough, but yeah, around here it obstructs a little bit. But I will show you once I go to the inside. The doors also, like handles, looks very nice, very flat profile. So in terms of driving this car, it's very good, like in narrow city condition, like the way it's designed. So this is the rear profile of the car. As you can see, obviously no halogen, no LED lights. This every single light in this car is halogen, like in the tail lights. And yeah, there is the roof spoiler, and obviously there is the antenna. No shark fin antenna in this car. You won't get shark fin antenna even in the Alpha model. High stop mount LED brake light. There is also a defogger type element. Little bit dust is there in this windshield. And obviously this is the rear windshield wiper. There is the washer placed here. And yeah, Ignis badging done there, Suzuki badging done there. Nothing more than that. Coming to the bumper, twin reflectors are there, and four parking sensors are there. The camera is placed under here somewhere here. And yeah, this variant doesn't get the camera. It's here actually. And the camera obviously doesn't get adaptive guidelines. Guidelines are there, but no, doesn't get adaptive guidelines. And yeah, reflectors I have already shown you. So from the rear, it kind of looks really very nice. It looks wide enough because of these bulged out wheel arches. There is the fuel filler cap. So talking about the dimension of this car, the length of the car is 3700 mm, the width of the car is 1690 mm, the height of the car is 1595 mm, and the wheelbase of the car is 2435 mm, and the ground clearance, as I have already told you, 180 mm. The fuel tank capacity is 32 liters. Very decent fuel tank capacity. Obviously this is not magnetically holding. You in this price segment, you won't get all those sorts of things. So these patterns here give it a very funky look. Now talking about the boot space, the boot space of the car is actually 260 liters. So there is the parcel shelf here. Also light is placed here, deep enough, wide enough. So for city, like urban condition, it's good. The rear seats also get 60-40 split seat. Obviously told you about the child seat anchor mounts, and there are also height adjustable headrest for both the side passengers. The middle passenger doesn't get head, so there is no adjustable headrest here. There is no headrest at all, leave about adjustable headrest. So yeah, it's deep enough, the boot space is deep. There is loading lip, but it's usable. In this price segment, you won't get lots. So this is the sphere wheel. Every single variant in the Ignis comes with a steel sphere wheel. You won't get full alloy wheel. So let's now put it back to the to its place. So it's a bit on the harder side. I don't want to make any mess. So the tailgate obviously gets twin struts. It's little bit tall. Obviously there is plastic done here, cladding is done here. Very simple. It's feels of really very nice quality. There is also a place here to put your hand and close it. So let's close and move to the rear interior. So before moving, talking about the doors, opens wide enough, not 90 degree. For that you have to go for the punch. And in terms of rivals, yeah, now the punch, Tata has launched the punch. So this car actually started the urban SUV segment. Earlier there were more cars, but Maruti Suzuki started the urban SUV segment with the Ignis, then came the punch. Now talking about the doors, opens wide enough, in-gas degrees will be good. Very simple, dual tone treatment is given, black and beige color, and this everything is hard plastic in all the variants. Chrome door handle is there, pockets are is there only for bottle holder, so nothing much more than that. Speaker is placed here. Scuff plating is done little bit here, which is really very good. So let's now move to the interior. So this is how the seats are, and one thing I have to say, the seats are well laid back than the punch. The punch rear seats are like very upright, and I didn't feel much comfortable on the punch, but here the seats are laid back nicely, so you can go for like a little bit longer drive in this car. And yeah, adjustable headrest, as I've already told you, 60-40 split seat is there. There is no armrest actually, which is kind of disappointing, but yeah. Then there are like 3-point seat belt for both the side passengers, 2-point seat belt for the middle passenger, but there is ISOFIX child seat anchor mounts, as I have already told you, which is really very nice feature. Little bit hump is there, so this car is good for like rear seating space is good for two adults and a single kid here, and obviously there is no armrest, so three people can obviously sit here, like two adults and a kid. Now talking about the knee room, the front seats are scooped out, so the knee room is really very great. My height is 5'5", even 6-footer people have nice knee room in this car. Obviously pocket is there in the front seat, and leg room, no worry, it's also very good. I don't want to talk about the headroom, it's really very good. The interior headliner also looks really very nice. Now talking about the under thigh support, it's decent in this price segment, you won't have to expect much. So here nothing is there, there is only a pocket. The front passengers can also use it, rear passengers can also use it, so it depends upon you. There is no USB socket, neither there is any like 12 volt socket. So yeah, could have been given, but it's not there. In the facelift could have been given, but it's not there. There are no rear AC vents. Obviously the cabin is small, so front four AC vents will cover it up, I hope so. And the window section, as you can see, the quarter glass here, it doesn't open, so it in this place it obstructs a little bit, but not much of an issue. The rear C panel section is a bit on the wider side. Blind spot can be there, but I have to drive it. So there are the handles, so all the passengers get handle, the driver doesn't get handle. There is no coat hook also, neither there is height adjustable seat belt, which I will talk in a bit. So that is the front of the car. It looks nice, dual tone treatment is given, but everything inside the Ignis is actually hard plastic, but the design is very funky to attract the youth. It's really very funky. So but if you compare with the punch, it's much more better because the materials feels really nice to touch. In the Tata punch, the plastic doesn't feel very nice, it feels very rough. So let's now move to the front, to the driver's seat there, and talk more about the car. So here you can see the request sensor on both the doors. There is request button, actually sensor is there. So once you press this button, the car will lock, and again once you press this button, the car will unlock if you have the key with you. So before moving into the interior of the car, I want to talk about the pricing of the Ignis. So the Ignis starts at 5.09 lakhs like the Sigma variant, and goes up to 7.06 lakhs for the top spec Alpha variant dual tone. And obviously for the AMT variant, you have to pay something like extra 50,000 rupees. So now moving towards the front, as I've already told you, the door handles get request button. So both the front doors get request button, also the tailgate gets request button. Now opening the door, dual tone treatment is given, hard plastic obviously. The door grab handle gets body color treatment, so if your car is blue, then you will get the blue body color treatment. If your car is white, white body color treatment. This car is gray, So gray grab handle is given, so little bit of funky treatment is done. Also in the center console there you can see the gray color treatment, and also those patterns that you see on the rear quarter section there, so it's given there. So funky treatment is done. And now talking about the door controls, auto up down function is there, like for the front doors, like auto down function is there. As you can see, auto down function is there, not auto up function. Auto up function could have been there, but yeah. So all four power window, this is the central lock button, this is the child lock button for window rolling up and down. This button is here for the electronically adjusting outside rear view mirror. Also electronic folding mirrors are there, with the press of a button you can fold it, like convenient features are there. Talking about the doors, so here the space is much more better than the rear door. There is a 1 liter bottle holder here. Also there is more spacing here to put some paperwork or cloth. Obviously speaker is placed here, tweeter is placed here. Now talking about the pedal situation, this particular variant is the AMT, so that pedal is there, kind of like it's done. Also in the manual variant you will get to see a similar side sort of that pedal. So brake and accelerator, obviously AMT variant. Talking about the seat, in all the variants of the Ignis you will get fabric seats, but the Alpha variant gets height adjustable seat. So 6-way adjustable seat is only available with the Alpha variant. If you want to get height adjustable seat like in the Ignis, you have to go for the Alpha variant. But different sorts of accessories are available, like leatherite seat covers and also leather wrapping for the steering wheel, which makes it much more like a premium to hold. Now moving to the interior of the car, obviously ingress degress is good, and yeah, the door or seals here also get like plastic scuff plating, which is also very nice. And now talking about the interior, this is the dashboard design of the Ignis. So very hard plastic, but it doesn't feel bad in terms of quality. It feels much more better than the, if you compare with Punch, because now it has a rival, like the Punch is also an urban SUV, so much more better than that. I have to say that the design is very funky. The AC vents looks really very nice. Both the side AC vents are round, the middle AC vents are like squarish kind of treatment. Also chrome treatment is given. Now talking about the infotainment screen of the Maruti Suzuki Ignis, this is the 7-inch unit that you have seen in every single Maruti Suzuki car, so I won't be talking about it. But in brief, it comes with Bluetooth connectivity. Also there is Android Auto, Apple CarPlay. The touch response is also really very good. It's sleek, the resolution is good, but little bit of glare is there. The only missing thing that I think Maruti Suzuki could have added with their infotainment screen, like in every single car, not only in this Ignis, is that the screen should get a dedicated volume knob button. I hate to use this volume control for like touch mount screen volume control, but yeah, this car, thankfully this variant came with steering mounted volume control, so it's much more easier to control the volume of this screen while driving. But even then, a dedicated volume button should be there. This variant didn't came with reverse parking camera, so I cannot show you the view of the reverse parking camera, but I will definitely give you the sound check. So let me first connect my phone, then I will talk more in details. So this particular variant of the Ignis came with four door mounted speakers. There are also two tweeters placed on its doors there and there. So yeah, this is how the music system in this car actually sounds. So that's in short how the music system in this car sounds. I personally like it. Mention in comment section below how you feel. Is it good? Is it bad? Now talking about more, there is this glove box which there are two like compartments are there. This is very spacious considering the size of the car. A very good practical glove box is given. Obviously you can see the dual tone treatment like black and beige, and in terms of safety this car comes with dual front airbag, so SRS airbag written there. There is also steering mounted SRS airbag. Now I'll come to the steering in a bit. This is the AC control. So in this price segment you don't have to expect much, but this car is offered with really very great features. So little bit of fit and finish issue is there, but everything here is very functional, very practical. So this here are the AC controls, manual, everything. So this variant doesn't come with auto AC. The defogger treatment is there, and this knobs actually feels nice to like control. The control is really very nice, the feedback is good, and these are obviously backlit. And yeah, this also is for the air circulation, which is manual. This is the blower control here. The AC in this car, like nowadays cars are really very great. So there is a 12 volt or 120 watt socket there. There is also a USB and aux socket here. The USB, you can connect your smartphone to the infotainment system there, and yeah, you can use it for like Google Maps or Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, all those sorts of features. Now coming to the down here, there is a place to put your phone here. No, this car doesn't come with wireless connectivity, or wireless charging is not there. And yeah, twin cup holders are there. There is also a cup holder here, as I've already told you. So this here is the manual handbrake. I am sorry, there is plastic, but yeah, manual handbrake is there, chrome like button is there, and this is the AMT variant. So there is the gear lever for like putting the car into gears. One thing I like about the Ignis center console is that this body color treatment, like very funky treatment, is given here. So that's really very nice. But yeah, it's a little bit flimsy, I have to say that. Quality control or little bit work could have been done, because this is sold exclusively by a Maruti Suzuki's premium outlet Nexa. So now moving to the steering wheel. The steering wheel is really very good, multifunction steering wheel. Then here is the button for controlling the MID there, which I will talk in a bit. The phone controls are also there. Suzuki logo is there. SRS airbag written here. 3-spoke steering wheel, sorry. Satin finish treatment is given. No, this doesn't get flat bottom steering wheel like the Swift. So this steering wheel also gets tilt adjustability, but there is no telescopic adjustment. Tilt adjustable steering wheel is given. And now moving to the controls, no auto like headlight control is there, neither there is rain sensing washer wiper. But yeah, these are placed very nicely, so it's really easily reachable. Now moving to the instrument cluster, this is the instrument cluster, and to the left side there is the analog tachometer, to the middle there is the analog speedometer, and to the right side there is the digital MID. So to control this MID, the button is here. So once I press this info button here, you can see like lots of information are showing. As you can see, the driving time is shown, then yeah, instant fuel economy is shown, then average fuel economy is shown. Also you can see the range, then average speed. Obviously lots of information are shown, and also this MID can also be controlled from the buttons here. Also this is for increasing and decreasing the brightness of this instrument cluster there. So you can see the brightness is like increasing and decreasing, as you can see here. And also trip details are shown from here only, so it's little bit on the slower side. Yeah, but yeah, trip A, trip B, as you can see, it's shown. And also other information can also be accessed from this button here. So both like info button is there on both the steering wheel and also in the dashboard there, which is kind of really very good. To this side there is the engine start stop button, and also to this side here is the headlight leveler switch. There are also lots of spaces for dummy buttons. And now talking about more of the interior, first of all talking about the seat comfort, the seats are really very comfortable. Obviously I don't have to talk about the leg room, because these seats, driver's seat is always adjustable. And yeah, under thigh support is really very good. The side cushioning is also done very nicely. The lumbar support is also very good. There is also height adjustable like headrest in the front seat, but the seat belts are not height adjustable. Could have been given, but it's not there. The sunset to the driver's side in all the variants doesn't get vanity mirrors, but there is a ticket holder here, and obviously it can be detach and move to the side here, but not much of any use because very huge area is left out here. So putting it back there and talking about the co-driver sensor, the co-driver sensors get a vanity mirror, but there is no light placed here. And yeah, there is a grab handle there, and this also can be used, but again same situation, large area is left out. The inside rear view mirror is manually adjustable, it's not like auto dimming inside rear view mirror. And there is the dome light here, only a single dome light is available here. There are the mic situation here, so this is also halogen LED, could have been given, but it's not there even on the top spec alpha variant. So this car doesn't even get reverse parking camera, so I cannot show you like the reverse parking situation here. As I put the car into reverse, you can only see the parking sensors getting activated in the MID. So you can get a reverse parking camera like as an accessory attached to this, because this display is compatible with reverse parking camera, but you won't get reverse parking. Even if you get reverse parking camera, you won't get like adaptive guidelines in this car. That's everything on the interior of the Maruti Suzuki Ignis. Let's now open the hood and talk a little bit about its engine. So talking about the engine bay of the Suzuki Ignis, first of all, the hood gets insulation. Obviously there is a single stud there, you cannot expect much in this price segment in a car. And obviously there is also insulation in the firewall, so the engine heat and noise doesn't go inside. And talking about the engine, this is the 1.2 liter 4 cylinder naturally aspirated petrol engine. Only single engine option is available in the Ignis that I've already told you. And in terms of power figures, this engine makes 83 PS of power and 130 Newton meters of torque. Yeah, it's obviously less than the one on the Maruti Suzuki Swift, which makes 90 PS of power, but Suzuki is like updating their lineup, so I think in coming year the 90 PS power engine will also be given in the Ignis. Now in terms of gearbox option, Ignis is offered with two gearbox option. There is a 5-speed manual and also there is an AMT. This particular variant is the AMT variant. So that's everything on the exterior, interior and engine details of the Suzuki Ignis. Let's now go for the drive impression. So right now driving the Suzuki Ignis Zeta variant that gets the 1.2 liter petrol engine, and this one came with the 5-speed manual gearbox. So first of all, talking about the visibility in the Ignis is really very good. The viewing angle from the driver's seat is wide enough, and obviously there is little bit of like blind spot area around the A pillar here, but it will not be an issue. People who like have experience in driving, but newer people might have, but that's not a big issue because you can always like driving is always, it comes with practice. Now moving forward and talking about other things, the outside rear view mirrors offer really nice viewing angles. The inside rear view mirror also offers nice viewing angle. And now moving to the controls, the steering really feels nice to hold. This particular variant didn't came with any leather wrapping. This leather wrap that you are seeing is an accessory. So the Alpha model also doesn't come with leather wrap steering wheel. You have to get it wrapped from the dealer. So lots of options or accessories are available with the Ignis. And now yeah, the steering at lower speeds feels really very light. At higher speeds it weighs up nicely. So typical Maruti Suzuki steering kind of feels same like the Swift, yet the feedback that you give of the steering wheel is very normal. It's not that much engaging for say. So yeah, very comfortable driving that it offers. And talking about the clutch feel, the clutch is really very light because this is a Maruti Suzuki car. So yeah, clutch is on the lighter side. And the engine, man, this is a very peppy engine. Maruti Suzuki cars are known for their peppy engine. So the braking performance is also really very good. All the variants in the Ignis comes with ABS and EBD as standard. Also there is dual airbags as standard. And now moving forward to other things like the NVH level, the NVH level is good. The engine really makes very sweet note. That's very lovely, very sporty character is like given. It's not sporty, but yeah, I hope you can understand what I am saying. And this variant doesn't come with height adjustable seat. Even then the visibility, I am a shorter guy, for me is good, but if you are much more shorter than me, then you can go for the Alpha variant that comes with height adjustable seat. The gear shifts are really very sleek, man. It's really very nice. Obviously, Suzuki cars are known for this, and particularly talking about other things like the real time or average fuel economy. I am right now getting around 18 km per liter, and this is the reason Maruti Suzuki cars actually sells. And look at the pulling, how it's pulling. The engine, as I've already told you, is the 1.2 liter engine with 5-speed manual gearbox. There is also AMT option, and the power that it makes is around 83 PS of power and 113 Newton meters of torque. So you won't feel any lack of power in this car. I have to say that. Yeah, it doesn't get the same engine like the Swift. The Swift comes with 90 horsepower engine, but even then, the driving is really very good, and it really feels very planted. As Maruti Suzuki calls it an urban SUV, the ground clearance of the car is really very good. So as it runs on 15-inch wheels, you won't feel much bumps, and the ground clearance really helps in going over bad patches. Now talking about city driving condition, the car really feels very compact from the driver's seat, and also since the Ignis has a very flatter profile and with a peppy engine, it is very easy to zip the car through traffic, which is also a very plus. Talking more about the Ignis, this car really feels very nice. And talking about this Jetta variant, this comes with manual AC for the auto AC, or that you get the cockpit style like switch controls for the AC. You will get that only in the Alpha variant, and also the LED lights, headlights that I'm talking about, the projector by LED headlights, you'll get that only in the Alpha variant. And yeah, the driving ergonomics, the suspension feel in this car is really very good. It's very smooth. The NVH levels are also really very nicely maintained. The steering doesn't get flat bottom steering wheel, even then it's good to hold, and obviously you can get the leather wrap treatment. And talking more, that's everything I have to say. Nothing much more to say about the car. Overall, a really very nice experience. That is the old Swift, which I like very much, more than the newer Swift, I guess.
So now coming to the main question, is the Ignis worth to buy? Well, with a peppy and fuel efficient engine, slick gearbox, comfortable ride, great ground clearance, it does feels nice. Also, the materials on the interior feels nice, and in terms of look, it looks very smart and the design is very funky. Even then, looks are always subjective. So under 8 lakh with premium Nexa features, I think the Ignis is a smart buy over other small hatchbacks. Even then, if you are confused, go to your nearest showroom, get a test ride and see what are your exact requirements. And for people of Jorhat, the showroom details are already given in the description below. You can also see right now running on the screen.
So if you are watching the video till now, hope you like the video. And if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and also press the bell notification icon to get notified every single time I upload a new video to this channel. Also, don't forget to share this video with your friends and family. That's it for today. Bye.